managed to endure the battle back to impact every game. And the Pack has witnessed many games where Cam has heated up and gone off on one of his amazing shooting displays, including, for that matter, in overtime. Back on Saturday, he gets a big round of applause, a standing ovation for most of the folks here at the Pack, and well-deserved. Cam McIntyre on Seniors Night sort of makes a lot of sense that he be honored as he gets some congratulations from the coaching staff as well on a day when he's the only senior graduating to be recognized in this way. One of the best Warriors ever to suit up in the black gold. And there he is. Continue to get some congratulations from his team as we get set for the beginning of this game. And it'll be a tough one for the Warriors, who just missed out on taking a game against Western, a team well ahead of them. And we chatted with Coach Kieswetter before this game, and he said he would have been a lot prouder of the effort had the Warriors not given up 21 offensive rebounds to Western. He said the Warriors had their opportunities to win but just didn't get it done, and the reality was the Warriors had a 12-point lead, so it really was the Ryan Barbeau show in the second half. 40 points of his 46 points. The Warriors managed to keep him pretty well non-existent in that first half, only scoring 6 points, but then comes back after the half and scores 40 to win the game. And we asked the coach to manage to do that against Barbeau. What can we expect from Harrison and Allen tonight, as they're the two big threats for the Golden Hawks? And Coach Kieswetter said they're both very dangerous, so the defensive challenges are huge, and wouldn't really let us in on a lot of what he's planning on doing. But he says, as the keys to the game for the Warriors tonight against Laurier, can't give up open three-pointers, and they have lots of shooters, do the Laurier Golden Hawks. Can't give up lots of offensive rebounds. Says the team must box out. It's been the story of the second half with Brendan Smith on his work placement. Warriors have had to do with a less than desirable front court with some big men, and certainly the folks like Figliano and Pejic and Klein have done a good job, but they've had their hands full against some real big men in the OUA West. And finally, the last key to the game for the Warriors: can't turn the ball over. And the Warriors need a good shot every trip tonight to put a W on the board in the final home game of the regular season for the Warriors. And it's been a tough season for these Warriors. Again, not qualifying for the playoffs, eliminated mathematically in the games at Lakehead a couple of weeks ago. So the Warriors playing for pride right now, and it does mean a lot. This is the last home game for Cam McIntyre, and we can expect some big things from Cam, who's had a couple of off nights the last couple here at the back, and he is a player that loves to play under pressure and clutch situations, and in a sense this is a clutch situation for his career, the final one. This game is not just about Cam McIntyre, also about Kel Harrison, the leading scorer for Laurier. He began the season 10th all-time in career scoring, now sits within the top six. Cam McIntyre cracked the top 20 in the all-time scoring points this season. He started with 1,261 points, and he's within the top 14. So we will see what Cam can bring to the table tonight, what Harrison and Allen will bring to the table. We're about a minute away from the national anthem and starting lineups here at the Pack in front of a good crowd on Seniors Night in the final home game of the season and our final webcast of the season. A reminder, the men's hockey playoffs tomorrow night, 7:30 p.m. from the Columbia Ice Fields. Adam McGuire will have the play-by-play starting at 7:30 on SSNCanada.ca. Just follow the link to men's hockey playoffs. Warriors just finishing their shoot around. You can see that on the right-hand side of your screen, Laurier still winding theirs down as well. This crosstown rivalry has been all Laurier for the last little while. The Warriors have not had that much success against this Golden Hawks team. It's a five-game losing streak against the Golden Hawks, including two games where the Golden Hawks scored over 110 points, including last time when the Warriors were down by a score of 110 to 60 back on January 4th. Time before that, January 8th, 2011, it was a 114-82 victory for the Golden Hawks. The last win by the Warriors was here at the Pack on February 18th, 2009, a 78-69 win. So all-time, the Warriors lead that all-time competition, head-to-head competition, with a record of 74-23 at home, 42-8. And we'll get into more of that momentarily, but first, the national anthem here at the Pack. For basketball here at the Physical Activities Complex on the campus of the University of Waterloo. I'm Sam Charles. This is Warriors Men's Basketball, brought to you by the University of Waterloo Athletics Department. The starters for the Wilfrid Laurier University Golden Hawks under 23-year coach Peter Campbell. That's 23 years coaching at the CIS level. He became the head coach 8 years ago at Laurier. They start number four, Kayla Harrison, the 6'5 wing player, 210 pounds, fifth year to Stratford. Number six, William Coulthard, a 6'2 guard in his first year out of Oakville. Number eight, Maxwell Allen, a 6'4 guard in his third year to Chatham. Number nine, Connor Machino, a 6'6 wing player in his fifth year. Number 12, Matthew Buckley, a 6'6 post player, fifth year at Waterloo. Assistant coaches are Alex Jurosevic, Eddie Lopez, Borko Kopic, and Andre Claxton. And it was a game-time decision, but we can see that Andrew Melbourne is playing in the second year, 6'2 forward. Wayne Bridge also starting, 6'2 in his third year in North York for the Warriors. Number 15, Zach Angelini. Number 20, Mike Wright, both in their second year. And we're just waiting for Wayne Bridge to be announced, and then we will go down to courtside to hear the reaction to this crowd for Cam McIntyre as we get set for his announcement. And he gets a nice round of applause from the Waterloo faithful here at the Pack in his final home game as a Waterloo Warrior. Cam McIntyre ready to go, as are the rest of the starters. We asked Coach Kieswetter, is there a bigger rivalry in your 20 years as a head coach than when you get to tip off against the Purple and Gold? And he said, no siree. This is the team that they have their sights set on every season. And the crowd rises to their feet, as is the custom here at the Pack, for the first Warriors basket. Klein wins the tip-off. Right over to Bridge from the charity stripe. Gets Harrison to back off over to Angelini for three. Left wing rattles out. Klein can't get there. Down with the rebound are the Golden Hawks. Buckley with the rebound. Harrison into the corner. Pacino kicks it out to Harrison. He'll drive in around McIntyre and kiss it off the glass for Laurier's first points of the game. 2-0. Laurier leads Waterloo. McIntyre drives to his left, stops, had the ball stripped for a moment, over to Klein. Then into Bridge. Bridge, one-on-one with Pacino, and he'll get the little teardrop to fall. And the Warriors knot it up at two, and the crowd can take a seat. They kick it outside. Coulthard almost loses the ball to the right. Into Allen. Then into Buckley. Buckley with a nice move around Angelini. Can't get it to go. Grabs his own rebound. And with the putback, that one drops. It's 4-2. Laurier leads early on. 8:40 to go in the first quarter. Our officials this evening, Al Robinson, Mike Hardy, and Tony Turnbull. Bridge into McIntyre for three. Near side. Hits it. His first one from the field tonight. Harrison slices into the paint, but can't get the ball to fall. Bridge with the rebound. McIntyre from the same spot. That one rattles out. Love to see Cam get that hot hand early on. Driving in is Coulthard. And then a little over-aggressive was Connor Machino. And Machino will pick up the foul. That'll be the first one of the ball game. First on him. We played 2 minutes of the first quarter with the Warriors up 5-4. Bridge uses a screen from Klein. Curls around the paint. Fadeaway jumper is good right over Buckley. Quickly, Coulthard and to Harrison. Just seemed to jump in the air and not want to come down. He gets that little jumper to go right past Coulthard. And that shot's off. Buckley with the rebound. Coulthard to Buckley. Outside to Allen. Back over to Coulthard. That shot's off. Buckley had pushed Bridge right out of the way. And Warriors still end up with the rebound. Angelini into Bridge. 12 on the shot clock. Over to McIntyre. Uses a screen from Angelini. But took a step or two and be called on to travel. Surgeon Pajic will replace Klein. Warriors lead 7-6, 7:08 to go in the first quarter. Coulthard, then into the corner to Buckley, to Harrison, one-on-one with McIntyre, to Allen, the pull-up jumper doesn't go. Long rebound picked up by McIntyre. Quickly up to right on a one-on-three. Mike gets past Harrison to Bridge in the corner. He'll drive in around to Harrison. Ran into Harrison. No whistle. Allen came down with a rebound. So Coulthard tried to just force it into Buckley. That doesn't go. Angelini over to Bridge, and the officials keeping the whistles in their pockets as Bridge goes end-to-end. He's fouled. Looks like Messino will pick up that foul. And it is, and that's his second. Second team foul on the Golden Hawks. Andrew Melbourne, we'd erroneously say was in the starting lineup. It was actually Max Klein. Melbourne was a game time decision for the Warriors with that ankle injury, but looked okay in warm-up. Bridge made the first. 8-2-6, Warriors lead. Angelini had some good position in the paint for that miss from the second shot from the free throw line, but no luck. Allen for three. That one's short. Pejicic grabs the rebound, gets some room, and then throws it away. Messino up to Harrison. Fake the shot, gets past Pejicic, and then a whistle on the far side. That's going to go against Sergeant. Melbourne will come in. He'll replace Bridge. First team foul on the Warriors. Harrison to inbound. Big lanky number four for Laurier. Into Allen. Into the Goldhart by himself over to Buckley, who just took too long, took too long in the paint, didn't realize he was by himself. Right. Angelini waits for the defender to get off his feet. Right. Gets past Sino over to Melbourne for a three from the corner, and he hits the long range ball. Coach Kieswetter said the Warriors need a good shooting night again and need to maintain that throughout the entire game. And not a good foul by McIntyre. Looked to be just a little too pretty and a little too much contact with Harrison. Cam, that'll be his first. Barry comes in. Along with Enright. Harrison, one-on-one with Wright into the paint, falls down, can't get it to fall. Buckley had it for a second, goes out of bounds, it's Warriors' ball. And Harrison gets up very slowly, waiting for a call. Pejicic will inbound. That's the NBA, there's no question that Harrison gets the call. One of the star players in the OUA, if not the CIS. Pejicic. I know he's a great outside shooter. Just couldn't get that little lay-in attempt to drop. Allen over to Enright. Enright up to Barry. Barry into Harrison. Wanting to get into Buckley. Stigliano into the game for the Warriors. Outside to Enright for three in the far corner, and he hits that one. Less than 5 minutes to go. In the first quarter, Warriors up by two. It's 11-9. Wright gets stuck, almost throws it away. Outside for three from the left wing. That one rattles out, and a good box out by Enright. Barry stops, gets Enright top of the key for three. That one's strong. Long rebound. Harrison picks that one up. He'll put up a shot that doesn't go, but a foul, maybe a makeup for the miss on the lay-in previously. Foul goes against Greg Stigliano. That's his first. Sergeant Pejicic takes a seat. Zach Angelini back in. Troy Stevenson came in the last substitution time moment for the Warriors as Harrison makes the first. Harrison, fifth in the OUA in scoring, averaging almost 18 points a game. And he's good on the back end as well. The game's tied at 11. Stevenson gets over half court. They try to trap him. They get to right by himself as Figliano waits for the defender to get past him. He nearly misses the lay-in by himself, but good heads-up play by Figliano. Gets it to go. Barry hands it to Allen. Allen over to Buckley. Back to Allen. He'll drive from the left side and is rejected by Figliano. 11 on the shot clock. Nice play by Greg. Buckley in his fifth year, graduating along with Harrison. Harrison with that nice move, but he's well short on the shot, and then it's Warriors' ball. Connor Messino is also graduating, and Matt Donnelly. So this will be a different team next season. Maxwell Allen is the one to watch, though. He is certainly going to take over the reins of this team. McIntyre to Bridge. Bridge from the corner, long two balls, no good. Enright with the rebound, nearly stripped. But that loose ball picked up by Allen. Harrison drives in, uncontested, and gets a little floater to go, tying the game at 13. 3.5 minutes to go in the first half. Pardon me, in the first quarter. Stevenson to the charity stripe, spinning around. Over to McIntyre, who loses the handle, but over to Stevenson, who shots up off the top of the glass. Figliano was there with the rebound, just couldn't put it in. And Buckley has it stripped. And both Bridge and McIntyre were there, and looks like it's going to go against Bridge. Justin Johnson replaces Figliano. Figliano with a couple of decent minutes there for the Warriors and gets some attention from Curtis Dauber and some instruction into the game is number 10, Jamar Ford, a second-year player, 6'3 guard out of Mississauga, replacing Harrison. Game's knotted up at 13. Allen and Enright to Buckley, and Buckley and Johnson get tangled up, and it looks like Johnson will pick up his first. That's the 15th foul on the Warriors, and we'll take Buckley to the line to shoot two. Laurier as a team, the men's side, is 7th best from the charity stripe in the OUA. Pardon me, make that in the CIS, averaging 74%. Second one is good. Pardon me, they're 17th. That was the Warriors I was chatting about. The 17th are Laurier. Angelini getting trouble, having trouble getting over half court. Does so to right. 72% is the percent. Bridge with the long ball. Johnson grabs the rebound and foul called against Barry. The mismatch there. Warriors would love to play every game with individual like Travis Barry standing at 5'10 in the paint. Warriors having that 72% from the charity stripe, 17th best in the CIS. The Warriors doing very well from the charity stripe. Just don't get as many opportunities as a lot of other teams. That three ball is a bit strong by McIntyre. One of three from long range so far tonight. Allen being guarded by Angelini. Over to Ford. And Enright loses the handle on the ball over to Angelini. And Angelini turns it over thinking that McIntyre or Bridge would be there. Allen into the corner. Enright for three. That's his second or third of the game so far. I think it's his second. Two of three from the field so far from beyond the arc. Right to Bridge to McIntyre. He'll put up a three from the near side. He hits it. Even though Barry had a hand, had two hands on his forearm. Brings the Warriors within two. It's 18-16. Allen to extend that lead does so with a tray from the top of the key. 5-point lead for Laurier over Waterloo, 21-16. Susan Pajic about to come back into the game for the Warriors. Nice pass from McIntyre over to right. Kicks it outside to Angelini for three. Left wing hits it. Great ball distribution by the Warriors. Allen will try to answer back and does so. Bridge was there to contest. Do not want Maxwell Allen for Laurier to heat up. Right fouled. That will be the fifth team foul on Laurier. Melbourne and Pajic, McIntyre and Johnson out. Marcel High, the second-year player at Scarborough, in, along with that name in just a minute as we look at our Adrian Walters, the first-year player to Vaughan. Melbourne. Into Bridge. Five on the shot clock. Bridge. Melbourne right for three. Long way out on the right wing. Rattles out. And the rebound picked up by Hyde. Hyde into Allen. Spinning around. Outside to Hyde. He'll drive in. Kicks it out to Enright for three. Hits it from the left wing. 27-19. Laurier leads. Coach Kieswetter said they couldn't afford to let Laurier have open threes, looks at her three, and that's what the Warriors have been doing thus far. Melbourne gets into the paint, has it stripped. Ford over to Walters, and he can't grab the handle. Warriors trailing by 8, 27-19, 28.9 seconds to go in the first quarter, and Wright will bring the ball very slowly down the floor, but a 4 or 5 second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. Bridge on the perimeter to Angelini. Wide open look for three. Top of the key. That one's short. Mike Wright comes out of nowhere to grab the rebound. Over to Melbourne. Seven on the shot clock. Bounce it up to Pejicic. Pejicic with 3 seconds to go. Gets some open room and hits it at the buzzer. Says a little salute to the sky. And at the midway point of the first half, the Warriors trailed 27-22. We'll take a break. You're watching Warriors men's basketball on Seniors Night on SSN. On the campus of the University of Waterloo. I'm Sam Charles. You're watching Waterloo Warriors basketball on SSN. Warriors coming into this game in the cellar of the OUA West with a record of 5-15. Laurier in second spot in the OUA West with a record of 16-4. Just one game ahead of McMaster with a record of 15-5. And 2 games behind Lakehead with a record of 18-2. ...27-22 as we start the second quarter. And Laurier will be inbounding. Leading scorer in that first quarter was Enright with his three balls. 3 of 4 from the floor. 9 points. Hide over to Enright, then to Allen. Back over to Enright, who misses the three-ball attempt that time. Now 3 of 5. McIntyre for a long range three from the left wing. Hits that one. McIntyre with now 9 points, the leading score for the Warriors. Tried to go for the steal. Allen into Walters and a foul with the reach in by Klein. Klein, that'll be a second, the first one on the Warriors. Walters and Enright take a seat. Sino comes in, as does Harrison. Tied for three. That one's off. Angelini's sword right up there. Got pushed in the back by Sino. No call. It is Laurier ball. Full shot clock. Allen inbounds. Into four, then over to Allen for three. That's off. Angelini with the rebound. And Zach, every night so far this season, has his hands full. He's not the tallest guy in the world. He's very strong, but having to play that number four spot. Wright steps up, puts up a three ball top of the key, and hits it right over top of Messina. Messina will try to answer back, hitting him in the paint. And then his foul looks like. And it is on McIntyre for Cam. That'll be a second. Second team foul on the Warriors. We've played 1 minute and 6 seconds of the second quarter. Allen lobs it up into Hyde. To Ford. to Allen. 13 on the shot clock. Messino, nice pass from Harrison. He easily finishes kissing it off the glass. Wright trying to get past Ford into the paint. Over to Klein, who hits it off the side of the backboard. That rebound comes out to Bridge, to Angelini. He'll drive in, puts it up. That doesn't go. The follow, that doesn't go. Klein was there for the rebound, but ripped out of his hands by Allen. Down to Messino. Quick turnaround move in the paint right around Bridge, and looking pretty and well organized are the Laurier Golden Hawks, but only leading by 3, 31-28. McIntyre, open look near side, 3, that one's strong. Harrison with the rebound. Into the corner, Allen gets Klein off his feet, up to Hyde, to Ford, running into the paint. Klein put up the hands to contest, and it goes out of bounds. Warriors ball. Buckley will re-enter replacing Allen. Klein will take a seat. Pejicic in. And Wayne Bridge being asked by Al Robinson to fix his attire as the shirt was hanging out. And that's going to cost the Warriors as they now have to substitute for Bridge. And Coach Kieswetter has a couple of words for Wayne as well. Melbourne gets it into Wright. 16 on the shot clock. Warriors down by 3. Melbourne into the paint, loses the handle. Outside to McIntyre, gets the defender off his feet. Pull-up jumper for 3, hits it. For McIntyre, that's now his 4th 3 in the ballgame, according to our unofficial stats. Ford gets past McIntyre, pull-up just inside the elbow, doesn't go. Angelini over to Pejicic, to Wright. Wright, 2-on-2 with McIntyre. No-look pass over to Melbourne, inside the arc, hits the long J just inside the arc, and the Warriors regain the lead. It's 33-31. Laurier just playing a bit sloppy in the past few minutes. Buckley with the right hook, doesn't drop. Surging down with the rebound to Melbourne. 2-on-2 with Angelini. Runs into Buckley. Buckley will... No, it's going to go against Harrison. Harrison, that'll be his first team foul. Into the game is Coulthard again. He will replace Hyde for Laurier. And Melbourne is at the line. Again, he was sidelined due to an ankle injury the last game against Western. Game in which the Warriors lost in overtime. Makes the first. Despite a very valiant effort, almost single-handedly by Cam McIntyre. McIntyre led the Warriors with 33 points, including 12 points in that overtime period. Coulthard uses a screen from Buckley, switches main, then he hands it off to Harrison. Wright went for the strip, doesn't go. Harrison grabs his own rebound, and then easily puts it in as the only person playing defense was Buckley almost for Laurier. In the way of Harrison. The two of them were fighting for a rebound. 6:14 to go in the first half. Warriors up by 2. Wright with a nice move, and he ran into Coulthard and Messino. Coulthard picks up the foul. That for him, that is his first, the second team foul on the Golden Hawks. Messino takes a seat. Figliano comes in replacing Angelini. Bridge in for McIntyre. Wright makes the first. Last time these teams met, it was Mike Wright scoring 25 points. The rest of the starters in that game for the Warriors scored 16. Warriors only managed 2 3-pointers in the whole game, dropping the game 110-60. Ford to Allen, back into the game for the Golden Hawks. Ford. Nice move to the basket. Misses, but Buckley's there with the easy follow. And he brings the Golden Hawks within two, 37-35. Bridge to Wright. Wright gets past Goldart. Help comes. Little fade away. Figliano grabbed the rebound, but his pass to the perimeter broken up by Buckley. Gets it to Harrison, who runs in to Bridge and picks up the offensive foul. For Harrison, that'll be his second foul. Third team foul, as you can hear, against Laurier. Warriors with two team fouls. McIntyre with two fouls. Harrison and Lucino with two for Laurier. Bridge, one-on-one with Harrison, spinning around, hands it off to Melbourne. Nine on the shot clock. Melbourne in the near corner, right in front of the Golden Hawks bench. Spinning around, wanting to use that pick and roll. Harrison gets right past Melbourne. On an odd man rush, has it partially blocked. Block number two for Figliano. Melbourne comes to help, and looks like Andrew will pick up the foul on the play, and he will. Very close to having Cal Harrison pick up a travel, but Melbourne will take a seat for Melbourne. That'll be his first. Troy Stevenson replaces him. Harrison at the line to shoot two. After one quarter of play, Harrison had 8 points. Kyle Enright was the leading scorer for the Laurier Golden Hawks after one quarter of play with 9 points, all from three-point land. Harrison looking to even up the score at 37. Puts it up, and it's good. It's 37 all. Substitutions coming. Enright back into the game along with Messina. Stevenson to Pejic. To Wright. Pejic to Stevenson. 12 on the shot clock. Pejic tried to get freed up with a screen from the far side from Figliano. Tried to return the favor with a pass right into the low post, but it's broken up by Laurier. Messino hands it off to Allen to the cherry stripe. Getting past Figliano, loses the dribble, and it goes out of bounds. Turnover again by Laurier, and the Warriors call a timeout with the score tied at 37, 4:31 left in the first half. Both teams were pretty good at not turning the ball over in the first quarter. It's not been the same story here in the second. Both teams having a little bit of difficulty. After the first quarter was 27-22, Warriors have come right back into this one. It's now 37 all. You're watching Warriors men's basketball on SSN. Come into this game on a one-game losing streak. So do the Laurier Golden Hawks. Golden Hawks lost last to Windsor, 77-69. Their last win, the game before against Guelph, 100-69. This is a team with a very potent offensive attack, as we mentioned. In the five straight losses by Waterloo to Laurier, two of them, the Golden Hawks scored more than 110 points. And a foul down low, waiting on the official call. Goes against Pejic. Fourth team foul on the Warriors, 4:16 to go in the first half. Game knotted up at 37. Goldart into Allen. Being guarded by Bridge. Bounces it to the far elbow into Buckley. Backing in on Figliano. He's got a lot more muscle on him. Misses. Loose ball. Goes off a couple of hands and into Troy Stevenson's hands. Stevenson comes towards the near side and then backs it up, curling back, spreading out the floor, up to Pejicic and the Bridge. Bridge wanting to get it to McIntyre. Matched up with Fulhart. Then he moves out of the way to Figliano. Nice pass from Bridge, identifying that Figliano was by himself, and Frank makes no mistake, nothing but net from right under the basket. Fulhart, everyone forgot about him. Banks it in, and a terrible inbound pass, trying to get past Messino from Pejicic. Tended for Stevenson, out of bounds. Laurier ball. Game's tied at 39. Both teams have led in this game. Laurier by larger amounts. Nice move by Buckley. Can't finish off the glass. Figliano down with the rebound. Bridge hands it to McIntyre, being guarded by Enright. And he gets past Enright, and all Enright can do is stick a hand out to slow Cam down. As we mentioned, McIntyre, the leading scorer in the game on Saturday with 33 points, including six threes. Wright replaces Bridge. And Cam makes the first. It's senior night, and the senior graduating is that very man, number 9 of the Warriors. Second one's up. That one's short. Angelini grabs the rebound. We approach the 3-minute mark. Left here in the first half. Pull-up jumper from Stevenson is off. Fulhart with a nice rebound. And throws it away, intended for Messino, running along that left side. Warriors up by a point. It's 40-39. Laurier letting the Warriors stick around, and the Warriors doing a good job of just that. Needing to tighten up on defense. Angelini gets his defender off his feet, pulls up, puts up a shot, and it's going to be three opportunities from the free throw line. You can't say that Zach didn't give every opportunity to Messino to just back up a second, and way too aggressive out there on the perimeter. And he pays for it as Angelini will go to the line to shoot three. To mention, the Warriors, 7th in the CIS in free throws made. Angelini, part of that, averaging 86%. And he's perfect from the line. Harrison will replace Messino. For Messina, that's his third, so we probably won't see much of him for the remainder of the first half. Fulhart gets to the left wing and then up to Allen, being guarded by McIntyre. Wright knocks that pass in 10 for Enright, out of bounds. Harrison will inbound. Warriors with Angelini, Figliano, Stevenson, McIntyre, and Wright on the floor. Harrison drives in, instigates some contact, and with a continuation gets the basket and potentially one. Figliano will pick it up. That's his second foul. Both teams in penalty. 2:27 to go in the first half. Johnson replaces Figliano. McIntyre, Pejicic, and Figliano with two fouls each. Messino with three, Harrison with two, and Barry with two. Harrison good on the three-point play, bringing his team within one. It's 43-42 of a very tight first half. Right. Angelini hands it to McIntyre. McIntyre uses a screen from Johnson. Switches are made down into Johnson. Johnson waits for the defender Harrison to get past him and banks it in. And that's what we want to see. We've seen a little bit of it this season, but what Coach Kieswetter talks about with Johnson is he needs and got caught out in the perimeter and no one was there to stop Buckley with the easy bucket down low. Needs to maintain that aggression and that aggressive activity down in the paint and be a presence during a consistent basis. Stevenson's three balls off. Johnson with the rebound, spinning around to Stevenson down low. Wait for some contact, no call. Grabs his own rebound, bounced it on the ground and lost control. Slow to get up. Harrison with it. Over to Allen for three. That one is short. Long rebound to the corner. Harrison steps on the baseline as he tried to save it. 1:26 to go here in the first as Stevenson takes a seat. Bridge in. Warriors up by one. It's 45-44. Wright bounces it into the post. Into Johnson. Gets past his defender. Nice bit of English on the ball, and he gets it to go. And he quickly gets back as Buckley had his team heading down court. Allen will drive in. Loses dribble for a second. McIntyre knocked it away, but right to Coulthard, who's feeling a hot hand from the field. Quick pass from Angelini up to Wright. One-on-one with Harrison. Waits for his teammates to catch up. Less than a minute to go in the first half. Warriors lead, 47-46. McIntyre, one-on-one with Allen. And it's knocked out of bounds. Official right there, Al Robinson, says it's Laurier ball. Good defense by Maxwell Allen, and he slowly gets up. Looks like he twisted his right ankle a little bit. Warriors bench clearly wanted a foul on the play, but looked relatively clean until McIntyre just sort of let his feet fly, knocking Allen down to the ground. Warriors up by a point, 47-46, 41 and a half seconds to go in the first half. High will bring the ball to the far side, set things up. Right in his face. Over to Harrison. Run. Angelini guarding him. He'll drive in, stop, pull up, jumper short. Wright knocks it right to Angelini, who hands it back to Wright. 21 seconds to go. Half a second difference on the shot clock. Hyde giving Mike the left side, and Mike will take it if you give it to him. Instead, he uses a screen from Johnson, loses his dribble, fight for the loose ball. Whistle as the game clock says 0.8 seconds left. And it's going to be a shot clock violation. That's what the buzzer was. Laurier ball, 0.8 seconds to go. And a little bit of confusion at the scorer's table. Looks like the Warriors are going to call a timeout. They elect not to. Allen will inbound. The long outlet pass. Alley-oop. Not so much from that far away. Tried the Hail Mary into Buckley, and Cam McIntyre got in the way to take it away, and the buzzer goes. Warriors up by a point at the half. We'll have some statistics and a guest coming up. You're watching Warriors men's basketball. They lead Laurier 47-46 on SSNCanada.ca.
I'm a warrior.
good start to the second half for a second quarter, make that for the Warriors as they outscore the Golden Hawks 25-19 in that second quarter, outscored 27-22 in the first quarter. Warriors are being led by their senior, Cam McIntyre, on senior night with 13 points in his 17 minutes, 2 rebounds, 4 of 6 from beyond the arc. He also turned the ball over 3 times, but a pretty good start for Cam McIntyre. Pretty hot, just missing those 2 shots from long range. Other scorers for the Warriors, Zach Angelini with 6, Andrew Melbourne with 7, Bridge with 5, Wright with 5, Figliano and Johnson with 4, and Pancic with a 3-ball for his 3 points, and the Warriors 47 points. Warriors out rebounding Laurier 21-19. Cale Harrison already with 15 points in the ballgame and 6 rebounds in just 15 minutes of play. Enright with 9 points, 2 rebounds, 3 of 5 from long range for the Golden Hawks. Maxwell Allen with 6. Coulthard and Messina with 4. Buckley also has 6 for their 46 points. The Laurier Golden Hawks turning the ball over 5 times. Warriors turning the ball over 9 times. Warriors got to the charity stripe 11 times. Good of 9 of 11. Laurier perfect 7 of 7 from the free throw line in the first half. Warriors shot 42% from the field. The Laurier Golden Hawks shot 43% from the field, including 5 of 12 from long range for 42%. Warriors 8 of 16 from three-point land for 50%. And that 50% much better than just the sole 2 three-pointers that the Warriors managed to get the last time these teams met in a 110-60 loss to the Golden Hawks at Laurier the beginning of January. We'll take another break and have more, including our second half, here on Warriors Men's Basketball on SSN. here at the PAC on the campus of the University of Waterloo. I'm Sam Charles. Thanks for joining us for Warriors men's basketball. Just getting set for the start of the second half. Warriors, after a half, lead 47-46, being led by their senior, Cam McIntyre's 13 points in his 17 minutes, 2 rebounds. He was 4-6 from long range. Currently just taking a little bit of a breather, and as we mentioned in the pregame when he was honored as part of Seniors Night for his contribution to this program, certainly one of the best to ever don the black and gold, and number 9, also known as number 34 for this Warriors squad, has had quite the career as a Warrior, and it wraps up at home here tonight, and then on Saturday at Brock University, his CIS career comes to a close, and it no doubt will be an emotional evening right now, and is an emotional evening for Cam, but also for his family, and we're hoping to get his dad, John McIntyre, to come over and chat with us shortly. And his dad has been to just about every game, if not every game, certainly here at the PAC, to cheer Cam on, and have that opportunity. Cam staying close to home, growing up in Kitchener, and now wrapping up his career here as a member of the Waterloo Warriors. Cam with those 13 points, Andrew Melbourne with 7, Zach Angelini with 6, Wright and Bridge with 5, Johnson Figliani with 4, and Pajic with 3. Cale Harrison with 15 points, 5 of 10 from the field, 5 of 5 from the charity stripe, 6 rebounds in his 15 minutes, 2 assists, 1 block, 1 steal. We did neglect to mention that Craig Figliano has 2 blocks so far. Enright for the Laurier Golden Hawks with an absolutely sizzling first half. He was 3 of 5 from beyond the arc for his 9 points, 2 rebounds. Maxwell Allen with 6 points. Messino with 4. Coolhart with 4. Buckley with 6. And then Ford with 2. Wrapping up their scoring for the Golden Hawks. It's 47-46. And we get set for the beginning of the second half. The crowd rises to their feet, waiting for the first Warriors bucket of the second half. Wright, McIntyre, Angelini, who's down by himself and finishes, and that's a very quick bucket. 12 seconds into the second half, and Angelini has a bucket. He's now up to 8 points. And a miss by Messino over to Wright. Wright one-on-one with Allen. Nice move. Can't get it to drop, however. And down with the rebound was Harrison. Over to Coolhart. That long shot is off, and Angelini grabs the rebound over to Cam McIntyre. And just in time, his dad, John McIntyre, joins us. And is this an emotional day for you as well? As I noticed you're going all the way through the crowd and Bridge with the lay-in from the right side, having to say hellos and thank yous to everybody.
We've had a long run at it, and we're going to... I phoned all my friends I used to play with, and they're all here. Few wives and a lot of family too.
Now it's been a 5-year career for Cam, and obviously one of the best Warriors players of all time. He must be very proud of his accomplishments.
Yeah, it was. I never thought it would be as good as he is, and I'll let you call that.
Okay, well that's a 3 from Ford, Jamal Ford, coming into. Into his playing days, these and minutes in his second year with the Golden Hawks. And for Cam, though, he obviously decided to stay home, play here at Waterloo.
Yeah.
When you used to play in the driveway with him,
yeah.
Was he the same sort of player? Could he call the shot from just about anywhere?
Oh, there was that. We used to have quite the family. His brother plays, his sister plays, so his sister and I used to play against...
and there's a long rebound, which Wright picks up.
Yeah, sorry, I'm ruining your flow here.
Well, that's okay. We want to hear all about it. As McIntyre nearly makes that one from way downtown. And he's become known for that, even in the loss, to Western on Saturday. He nearly made a turnaround shot from basically standing right beside Tom Kieswetter at the bench the waning seconds of that overtime.
Yeah, it was a hope shot. He had to rush it. I think there was about 2 seconds left, and if he got set, maybe he had a better chance at it. But anyway.
Sometimes I watch Cam, and I just think he doesn't even have to get set. As long as it's in his mind that the ball is going to go in, he can make it.
I like it better when it gets set.
Probably the whole coaching staff, the whole team does as well.
Yeah.
Bridge at the line to shoot two. Warriors up by two. It's 51-49. What's your fondest memory? And have you been to every home game at least?
Yep. Well, I go way back. The Naismith Classic had its 43rd.
Yeah, I think you're right. Yep.
I think I've been to 40 of them.
Wow.
I started going when I was in high school, followed the team. I was here for the national championship. I was sitting right across there at center court, and it was quite emotional.
Allen with a nice lay-in from the right side, bringing the Golden Hawks within one. It's 52-51. Angelini for three, hits it from the right wing, and Zach is super hot from long range tonight.
I was talking to Zach's dad before the game, and he said, boy, it was nice to see. On that, like, he had a career day on Saturday with 28 points, and I was just, you know, I can't say enough about this team. Mike Wright with 13 or 14 assists, whatever that was. You know, I look back, there was a game where Matt Hayes had 18 or 19 rebounds in one game.
Yes, and that's a nice play by Zach with the turnaround. Having to play that four spot, and we'll see if the coaching staff can recruit some bigs for next season. That's going to change the whole dynamic because the Warriors, without a doubt, have some of the best guards in the CIS.
Oh, definitely. Mike Wright has been just a godsend. He's a heck of a player. And sorry. I'll let you say that.
Well, that's all right. That's good analysis as Wayne Bridge tries to walk that tightrope and doesn't quite manage it. It goes out of bounds and the turnover, and Laurier will pick it up. Warriors leading 57-51 with Harrison to inbound. And what's been Cam's disposition? He's been to the playoffs twice with the Warriors,
right,
with some victories at Guelph and also at MAC. Has it been a bit frustrating not to get to the playoffs
so.
A little bit
yeah,
more often?
Like the one year that they had a chance, that was when Frisbee with them, you know, and Matt Hayes and those guys ran into some injury problems. And yet I look back at that year and I said, you know, that was your chance. They went up to Lakehead. They were ahead at halftime. Disappeared the second half. They lost by 5 or 7 or something like that. And I said, you know, you beat them, then you're on your way sort of thing. Anyway, it's frustrating to go out on, you know, as the doormats this year. But, hey, he's had a good run. And
I would imagine, I mean, obviously you're very proud of him. The family is and all the program is, for that matter. Harrison one-on-one with Wright. And Wright manages at half his size to still give him a little bit of trouble, but he still banks it in from the left side. But is he proud? Do you think is he proud of the accomplishments as a Warrior as well?
Yeah.
McIntyre with the right hook. That's a bit too strong. And Harrison come down with a rebound with 6:02 left in the third quarter. Warriors now up by a basket. It's 57-55, and a reach in foul looks like it'll go against Melbourne. And Andrew does pick up the foul.
So I got something to talk to you about.
Okay. Happy to hear.
I'm not sure how many listeners you have, but I've tried to listen to other games. They don't hold a candle to you. You are the most accurate. You have a lot of anecdotal information and stuff like that. It's a pleasure to listen to you. I only watch it on the replays, obviously, but, you know, I just... Anyway, I commend you for your knowledge and your professionalism at this, even though it's probably volunteer, but anyway.
Well,
and thanks to SSN for all they do, too.
Well, thank you for that. But, you know, I would you like to also mention, while you have an opportunity, to sort of thank anybody in the program or all the families and friends as well that have offered Cam support and your family support over the years?
It meant a lot for us to have Brad Johnson as the in that picture taking at the start. Brad has been with Cam through the Vipers, and there was a...
some offensive rebounding. Nice block by Figliano. That's his third of the ball game.
But Brad Johnson is... Anyway, he said it would be a pleasure. Welcome, Mike.
Mike Wright, with glue on his hand, stops. And I think that was more for show than anything else because he had the defender beat completely. Buckley out to Harrison for a long three. That one's strong. And Mike Wright nearly grabs the rebound amongst a whole bunch of Laurier towers in the paint. Buckley with a strong move around Bridge and gets that one to draw. Sort of the story, unfortunately, of the season the Warriors. Yeah. Just nobody to grab those boards. And when you have Mike Wright, who is a great basketball player and has some great hops, but when he's up against guys that are basically twice his size, nice play. Nice pass from Bridge to Stevenson. Finishes from the right side. 4-point lead for the Warriors. Harrison tries to get past Bridge. Help comes. Looked like a walk, but no call. Outside to Allen. Little floater is strong. Grabs his own rebound. Takes down his dribble and will slow it down, getting it up top. Hyde, number 7 for the Golden Hawks. Into Allen. Up to Ford. 8 on the shot clock. To the right wing to Hyde. He'll drive in. Kicks it outside. Allen near corner for 3. That one short. Good box out by Pajic. Gets it to Bridge. Bridge to Stevenson. To the elbow. Pull up jumper. Strong. And Bridge had some good position. Couldn't corral the rebound. Hyde. Nice pass into Allen. Nearly blocked by Wright. Cleanly, we should say. It was blocked, but cleanly, and he picks up a foul for Mike. That will be his first personal, and that's the 3rd on the Warriors team.
I always like the idea of a second opinion on those calls. Look pretty clean from here. Of course, we're about 120 feet away. But
Well, and sometimes with a person of Mike's stature with that height, you almost want to give him that block. Unfortunately, don't get any handicap for that being the size factor in basketball, unfortunately. So with 3:54 to go in the third quarter, Allen makes them both, and it's 61-59. Warriors have more than hung around with the Golden Hawks, certainly after the game back at the beginning of January where the Warriors were blown out by 50 into McIntyre. Nice kiss off the glass. And seemed to want to take every 3 opportunity in the first half, now electing to go inside a little more often with a great deal of success.
Good help for Switch.
Spinning around, he is forward. His shot's well short, well guarded by Angelini, and McIntyre comes up with the rebound. Can with a beautiful pass to Angelini, who just can't finish. A bit too strong off the glass. Ford up to Harrison, and a little too quick, and Bridge saves it.
Great effort by Wayne.
Did just about everything he possibly could to keep the ball in bounds, but his body slid out of bounds. Some substitutions coming right back into the game, and Johnson. So you were finishing, I'll let you finish the point about Brad Johnson, that he's able to be here and to be a part of Cam's basketball life.
Right, yeah.
And I guess life in general for that matter.
True, yeah.
And how important are those sort of coaches in his career?
Well, always. Like, whenever I saw him, I always said to him, the more looks you get, the fact that he changed high school coaches halfway through, from junior to senior, there's another guy with another insight, another set of rules, another, opportunity to learn from, and that's always been important.
I've also noted I think I've been doing this for 4 years now, Cam's become a lot better defensive player, too. Like he'll be very aggressive. He used to just try those little sneak steals here and there, and now he knows when to plant the feet, draw the offensive charge, that sort of thing.
Yeah.
Stevenson. Come on, pull up, left side, and that one rattles out. Down with the rebound is Enright, who we haven't heard from much. He had 3 3-pointers in the first quarter. Out to Allen, down into Buckley, one-on-one with the mismatch with Stevenson, and easily gets the right hook over him. Warriors switching it around on defense, but as again we've mentioned all season long, not a lot of solutions to anything that occurs in the paint, except for maybe a 3. McIntyre, beautiful move, and finishes. Hyde, bounce fast, and right for 3. That one was a little too fast for him. But Hyde grabs the rebound, back over to Enright. He'll try that one again, and that one's strong. And Johnson comes down with the rebound amidst 3 Golden Hawks. McIntyre, one-on-one with Hyde. 4-3 is well short, and Justin Johnson.
That's one of those shots I wish he wouldn't take. Anyway. if he's feeling it. And
yeah, and there's so many times when, I guess in his entire career, you've sort of seen that same thing. But when he's hot, there could be three hands in his face, two people grabbing him, and he'd still be able to make the shot.
I go back to that crazy game last year where he had 25 points in the quarter, including 22 in a row, including 5 3-pointers in a row. Not that I haven't watched that a few times with your commentary, by the way, and Matt Hayes. But it was, I just was shaking my head. I was sitting in a in the crowd with a friend of mine who we still play.
And that's a miss by the Golden Hawks again, and Angelini with a strong rebound. And the Warriors doing a much better job. Tom Kieswetter was so upset, not necessarily relinquishing that 12-point lead against against Western, but the fact that the Warriors gave up 21 offensive rebounds in the ballgame. Even asked him, you know, what about Ryan Barbeau's huge 40 points in the second half? And he just said, it was the offensive rebounds that killed us. And, you know, Cam's miss and that three-pointer was a very tough shot near the end of overtime. Yeah. But there was also an offensive rebound that they gave up to Western that they had to get that rebound to finish the game. And probably it would have resulted in a win had they been able to. And
I happened to read the stat line. They were rebounded 53-35. Well, you're out-rebounded by 18 and lose by 3 in overtime. You need some height out there.
Yep, absolutely. And hate to keep dwelling on the fact, as this team has worked about as hard as they possibly can, but there's so many good shooters, but there are days when all those good shooters, Cam included, you're just not going to, can't buy a basket. Yeah. It's just the way the game is played. McIntyre with three, Pajic with three, Figliano with two, and Klein with two as well. Five team fouls now for the Warriors with less than a minute to go in the third quarter. And Harrison makes the first. And he is also a very smooth player in his fifth year. Both Cam and Hill Harrison entering the season just continue to climb the ladder up the CIS all-time scoring record.
Right, yeah.
And both of them, you know, coming to the end of their careers, but impressive. Melbourne, far side, 7 on the shot clock. He'll drive into the paint, has it stripped by Harrison, quickly puts the shot up, and
nice
will make the shot and go to the line.
Attaboy, Drew.
And have to remember that Melbourne is dealing with a very sore ankle. It was a game-time decision for this Warriors team.
Good decision.
Indeed. And he'll go to the line for the three-point play. 36.9 seconds to go in the third quarter. Warriors up by 4. Melbourne looking to extend that. Shot is up, and it's good. As we mentioned, the Warriors top 7 in free throw percentage in the CIS. But a 10-second differential with the shot clock and the game clock as Barry gets it in and right. That one's off again. And Angelini may have thwarted an opportunity by the Warriors because Melbourne had pretty good position for the boards. But it's Laurier ball. No shot clock now and 21.4 seconds to go in the quarter. Barry up to Messino. Messino puts it up short. Johnson down with it.
15.
And Mike is so fast, Mike Wright with the ball currently, that he probably needs about a second and a half from where he's standing right now. Sometimes you do think he takes a little too much time. 4 seconds to go to the elbow. Puts up the shot off the glass. Gets it to go at the buzzer.
Beautiful, Mike.
And the Warriors lead by 7 heading into the final quarter. And John McIntyre, the dad, very proud dad of Cam McIntyre. Thank you very much for joining
us. My pleasure.
And
I hope I didn't,
not
didn't
at all.
Dissuade anybody from listening to you guys. Thanks a lot for the opportunity.
Thank you. We enjoy having guests like Mr. McIntyre, and he'll enjoy the rest of the game with his family and friends, as he mentioned, here at the pack in the final home game for his son, Cam McIntyre. Very proud father enjoying this ball game as the Warriors lead by 7. It's 70-63. We'll take a break. You're watching Warriors men's basketball on SSN. I am a warrior. I am a warrior. I am a warrior. I am a warrior. Warriors lead. It's 70-63 as we are at the midway point of the second half. A reminder that the OUA Wilson Cup men's basketball Final Four in the OUA takes place right here at the Physical Activities Complex on Friday, March 2nd at 6 p.m. with semifinal number one, 8 p.m. semifinal number two, and then the Wilson Cup championship game at 8 o'clock on Saturday, March 3rd. From the pack, for ticket information, visit GoWarriorsGo.ca. Harrison to Allen. To Harrison, driving in, gets it to go with the lay-in. And the Golden Hawks able to execute their play to start off the fourth quarter. Wright, pull-up jumper, that one's off, fight for the rebound, Allen comes down with it. Cale Harrison, the played for Canada's FISU team in the summer, is a foul called. One goes against Angelini. Shooting foul. And the Wilfrid Laurier Golden Hawks, and certainly Coach Peter Campbell, know that this is perhaps their best opportunity to advance to the CIS championship this season. Certainly want to get to the Wilson Cup here in a quasi-home game, as Harrison misses the second, and Johnson with a good box out of Enright grabs the rebound. Angelini to Johnson, hands it off to Bridge. Bridge drives in, pull up at the near elbow, it's off. Johnson just couldn't corral the rebound, goes out of bounds. It is Laurier ball. Peter Campbell, the head coach of the Golden Hawks, OUA Coach of the Year in 2001-02, 23 years coaching in university basketball in the OUA, 15 at Laurentian, 7-time OUA East and 1-time OUA West Coach of the Year, and he's led this Hawks team to the playoffs each of the last 7 years, and his team is come right back into this game. They were down 70-63 to after three quarters, and it's 70-68, and we've played just 1 minute and seven seconds of the fourth quarter. You're watching Warriors men's basketball on SSN. Golden Hawks finished in third in the OUA West last season, currently sitting in second. They're on a one-game losing streak after a loss to Windsor. The Warriors also on a one-game losing streak after that overtime loss to Western on Saturday. And it's left a bad taste in their mouth, and they are looking to make Seniors Night that much more memorable for Cam McIntyre. Coach Kieswetter, in his 20th year as head coach of the Warriors, said there's no bigger rivalry for this Warriors team than the Golden Hawks. McIntyre, nice move to the basket, and Mac and Bridge is there to grab that loose ball and put it in off the glass. Allen stops, out to Barry, being guarded by Bridge. Bridge giving him the left side, so he'll now go to the left side and then stop. 13 on the shot clock, hands it off to Allen. Warriors playing loose zone. Get into Buckley, spinning around Figliano, and block number four, leaving 3 seconds on the shot clock. Block number four for Greg Figliano. And he has some words for Buckley. They get it into Buckley, spinning around, and Figliano, I think, partially blocked that one, too. Wright driving in from the right side. Hands it off to Figliano. Gets the defenders off their feet. And he can't finish. Loose ball, though, picked up by Wright. Hands it off to McIntyre. And the official on the near side says Cam stepped on the sideline. Warriors turn the ball over. They lead by four. It's 72-68. Less than 8 minutes to go in the second half. Barry goes to the far side. Getting it up to Enright. Back to Barry for three. Well short. Allen's there. Enright, right wing, hits it. It's been quiet. He's now 4 of 9 from long range. He had three 3-pointers in the first quarter. Wright gets right past Buckley and then stops. Cross-court pass to Bridge. Bridge, pull-up jumper just inside the perimeter. Nothing but net. 74-71, Warriors lead. Coach Kieswetter, one of the keys to the game was don't give the Golden Hawks open looks for three. They get it down into Harrison. Help comes from Figliano. Long rebound, and Warriors were caught just watching the rebound. Out to Enright. Three. That one's off. Long rebound. Harrison grabs that one. McIntyre went in for the steal. Gets past Figliano, but misses. Does Harrison, and Figliano grabbed the rebound, gets it to Wright. We thank the father of Cam McIntyre, who puts up a three ball. That one's short from in front of where his dad's sitting right now, for joining us in the third quarter. McIntyre, the little floater, and he just landed hard on his head. And you could hear that from our position up here as the officials wait for a second. See if McIntyre is going to be okay. The training staff come over. Never want to see that in a game, as Cam coming down hard on his on the fall and just bouncing his head off the hardwood here at the pack. Still on the ground, appears to be in a great deal of pain. We'll take a quick break and hopefully have a report for you. We're watching Warriors basketball with the Warriors up by three. It's 74-71. You're watching Warriors basketball on SSN. Cam McIntyre finally getting up on all fours, fortunately. The crowd is completely hushed here on Seniors Night, a night to really celebrate Cam McIntyre, and he's very slow getting up. He gets a well-deserved round of applause from the crowd. Hit his head hard on that last play. And Cam, who has had to deal with an injury riddled career as a member of the Warriors, has another one to deal with, and puts a hand on his back of his head, and I'm sure he'll have a bit of a headache at the very least. Still grimacing as he gets down and has a seat on the bench. Andrew Melbourne will replace Cam McIntyre, who's still being assessed by the training staff at the Warriors bench. Laurier ball. And if we can get a report from you, for you, we will, as this fourth quarter continues. That has certainly silenced the crowd. And Warriors looking to, we're looking for some inspiration from their captain and senior, Harrison. He is pushed by Figliano, and for Greg, that'll be his third foul. That's his third, the second team foul. Golden Hawks with no team fouls at this point. Messina has three fouls, Harrison with two, and Barry with two, along with Buckley also with two, Warriors with Klein with two, McIntyre with three, Pajic with three, and Melbourne with two. Wright and Pajic play a little catch, getting the ball over half court. They get it over to Surgeon, then into Bridge. Bridge up to Melbourne, nine on the shot clock, being guarded by Allen. The switch is made. Harrison went for the steal. Melbourne with a strong move to the basket and a blocking foul called against Buckley. They, Laurier Golden Hawks, threw about everything they possibly could at Melbourne, and he sliced and diced through that defense and has Buckley pick up a foul. For him, that's his third, the first team foul. And Melbourne will go to the line. He had 10 points after three quarters of play. Cam McIntyre, leading scorer for the Warriors with 17. Zach Angelini with 13. As Melbourne misses the first. Wright with 9. Bridge with 8. Johnson and Figliano with 4. Pajic with 3. And Stevenson with 2. Leading scorer for Laurier is Cale Harrison's 19 points, 9 rebounds. Max Allen with 10 points, 3 rebounds. Buckley with 12.7 rebounds. Enright with 9 points heading into this fourth quarter. And Coulthard and Messina with 4, Ford with 5. Allen with 6 on the shot clock. Out to Enright. 4 on the shot clock. Bridge right in his face. He'll put up a shot and get it to go just as the shot clock expires. Good play by Enright. The third-year man at Oakville for the Golden Hawks. Wright gets past Buckley, puts up the floater. And it's good, and Mike will go to the line for a three-point play. Pulling the Warriors up by two at this point. It's 77-75. Bridge takes the seat. Angelini replaces him. Nearing the midway point of the fourth quarter. Cam McIntyre. Figliano just missing getting that rebound on the miss on the back end. Has an ice pack on his head. They get out to Allen. Bounce pass to Harrison. Wide open look from the left side. It's short. Fight for that loose ball and somehow gets into the hands of Zach Angelini. Bounce pass to Melbourne. Bump by Barry. Shot is up, miss. Good box out by Buckley on Figliano. Allen over to Harrison, down to the baseline to Barry by himself. Bounces it over to Buckley, spinning around. Kicks it outside to Allen. 14 on the shot clock to the corner to Barry. For three, that's off. Long rebound to Wright. Wright will go up and bank it off the glass. Barry tried to catch up, but Mike Wright is just way too fast. Harrison elects to back it up again, and then he'll curl back into the paint, spinning around, kicking it out to Allen, to Buckley by himself, who's blocked, and a late call down low. There was definitely some contact. That would have been the fifth or sixth block by Greg Figliano. He had three after the three quarters of play. Coulthard will come in, replacing Barry. Johnson will replace Figliano. Figliano now has 4 fouls, unfortunately, for the Warriors. Coach Campbell of Laurier says that Will Coulthard has the ability to make the Golden Hawks a better at the point guard position. And he has some very high praise for Coulthard in his first year, as well as Adrian Walters. He says both those players have given the Golden Hawks better depth than they had last season. Buckley comes out into the game, seeing his first action is Sharif Wanas. Wright gets past two defenders, hands it off to Angelini, tries a reverse, and it falls. 81-77, Warriors lead. And they have had a solution for this Golden Hawks team all afternoon, as Enright maybe not for him necessarily, in the first quarter and the last quarter as he makes another three. He has five for the evening here at the pack. Good screen by Johnson, making Hullard pay. Wright with a little floater, doesn't go. Johnson grabs it. And Juana steps on the baseline after saving the ball from going out of bounds. Juana, a fourth-year player to Burlington. 3:50 to go in the second half. Warriors up by a single point. It's 81-80. Peter Campbell wanted some clarification from the officials, and he got it. It is Warriors ball. Inbound to Johnson. Over to Wright. Three from the corner. Hits it. 4-point lead for the Warriors. Allen bouncing up and down in the paint and gets the ball to drop. Wright gets past Coulthard. Out to Angelini, who is bumped in the face by Harrison. That'll be Harrison's third foul. And that's the fourth team foul on Laurier, and a timeout quickly called by the Purple and Gold, who were off to a hot start to start off this game, leading by five after one quarter of play. The Warriors then outscored Laurier 25-19 in the second quarter and 23-17 in the third. And it has been seesaw all the way through this fourth quarter with the Warriors up by a basket. It's 84-82. We'll take a break. You're watching Warriors men's basketball on SSN. A congratulation to Graham Kemp from Warrior Swimming, the male athlete of the week, along with Kate Quincy from the women's basketball team as female athlete of the week. And while we have this stoppage in play, just going to go over again our Warrior Awards for this season. Most improved player, as selected by Coach Kieswetter, Mike Wright. Worked hard and put in a lot of practice, according to Coach Kieswetter, to improve his game to become an effective point guard. The player who epitomized the Warrior this season, Zach Angelini. Despite being overmatched, the four-spot power forward, he battled every trip and was quite productive. Warriors inbounding. Bridge inbounds to Wright. And the player that Coach Kieswetter is expecting the biggest strides from, Hayicic for three. That one's strong. Johnson fighting for the rebound amongst three. Golden Hawks gets it out to Hayicic for the charity stripe. Over to Angelini. Right wing for three. He hits that one. And it's 87-82. Coach Kieswetter is expecting big things from Mike Wright next season as well. Allen inside. Inouanis, who has the ball stripped by Angelini, but because of a reach-in, according to the officials. And that's the fourth team foul on the Warriors. And it goes against Angelini. That's his second. Coach Kieswetter said the highlight of the season was beating Ryerson twice at home during the Naismith and at Ryerson. Both games, Cam just went off 34 points and 31 points, and Cam still with the ice pack on the back of his head after taking a tumble in the front court. So the low light of the season for Coach Kieswetter was being embarrassed in Ottawa, losing to both Carleton and Ottawa after a decent start to the season. Juanes replaced by Buckley. 2:54 to go in the second half, and the Warriors are up by three. It's 87-84. Right, beautiful pass to Bridge, who has it partially blocked by Harrison. Right, threaded the needle. Coulthard for three, rattles out, fight for the rebound. Long rebound comes out to Harrison, hands it off to Allen. That one rattles out. Buckley had it for a second. Coulthard to Harrison for three, left wing. That one is off. Fight for the rebound again and again. Laurier comes out with it. Does Enright out to Coulthard? The crowd getting a little bit frustrated by the lack of defensive boards here. Out to Enright for three. That one he hits. Now with six threes in the ball game. And the number one key of this game for the Warriors was don't give Laurier any open looks from long range. And the Warriors have done, unfortunately, just that. The game is tied at 87. It comes down to the last 2 minutes of regulation. Pigliano out to Angelini for a long three. That one's strong. Fight for the rebound. Greg grabs it, and he trying to kick it outside. Banks it off a Laurier player, and Allen comes up with it. Coulthard. And Enright. Back over to Coulthard. Spinning around on Angelini. Finds Buckley by himself. Help came for Figliano, and Angelini wasn't there. And Laurier has a lead again as Coach Kieswetter just trying to find an answer. Less than 90 seconds to go, and the Warriors now trail by a basket and have called a timeout. You're watching Warriors men's basketball on SSN. Coach Kieswetter's big thank you this season. He said, despite the Warriors' poor record, he's very proud of the team because they didn't give up on themselves and they battled until the end. And we see that even today against one of the best teams in the OUA West, the Wilfrid Laurier Golden Hawks, who demolished the Warriors in the beginning of January. Downing the Warriors 110-60, embarrassing the Warriors. The Warriors have held fast here at home. Warriors on a five-game losing streak against Laurier, including two games where the Golden Hawks scored more than 110 points. Warriors' last victory against the Golden Hawks here at the Pack, February 18, 2009, a 78-69 victory. All time, the Warriors are well up on the Golden Hawks, 74-23, and at home, 42-8. And a special thank you to the Backboard Club, the boosters for this Warriors squad. You can find out more about them by just Googling or going to your favorite search engine. Pull-up jumper from right, from the near elbow, hits it. Tying the game at 89. And you can find out, check out that search engine. Type in Warriors, Waterloo Warriors basketball, and you will find out just about everything you ever want to know about the Waterloo men's basketball program since it began. Great website, and kudos to the folks over at the Backboard Club for their efforts. Certainly Brian Beckberger and Trudy Beckberger, but all the rest of the folks at the Backboard Club for maintaining that site. Harrison. Takes, looked like four steps, but he's got some pretty long strides, and he kisses it off the glass, and he's a player that can take control of a game. Warriors trailing by a basket with 50 seconds to go in regulation. Right around. Buckley lays it in with the answer. 91 all. Warriors need a stop. Less than 40 seconds to go. Coulthard gets past Pajic. Pull-up jumper just inside the charity stripe. That one falls, and a timeout called by the Warriors. 34 and a half seconds to go. They trail by a basket, 93-91. You're watching Warriors men's basketball on SSN. This is our last regular season home game and our last webcast for the season. We really appreciate you joining us, whether it be live or in the archive form at ssncanada.ca. These games all brought to you by the University of Waterloo Athletics Department. Visit gowarriorsgo.ca for the latest on recreation and varsity athletics and everything you need to know about March 2nd and 3rd when the Wilson Cup is hosted by the University of Waterloo. Games at 6 and 8 on the 2nd, and then that final 8 p.m. on the 3rd of March. Check out GoWarriorsGo.ca for ticket information and the like. Warriors wrap up their season on the road at Brock on Saturday. We have a lot of people to thank for their efforts and contribution to our webcast. And if you have any comments, suggestions, criticisms of our broadcast, how we can make them better, we'd love to hear from you. Go to GoWarriorsGo.ca and track down the email address for either Dan Ackerman or Chris Gilbert, our executive producers, and they will pass those messages along. We'd really like to thank the coaching staff for both squads, Tyler Slip for the women, Coach Kieswetter for the men, for providing us with lots of insight, very helpful and an important part of our webcast to bring you the latest on what's going on with these teams. 30 seconds to go. Right to Vigliano by himself, gets it to drop. The game's tied with 26.9 seconds to go. Warriors finishing that play perfectly out of the timeout. And some whistles on the play. Substitutions, and now Laurier calls a timeout, a delayed timeout it seemed, as that's what both teams were anticipating would happen. 26.9 seconds to go. The game is tied at 93. Warriors, if you'll remember, had a 12-point lead several times against Western and then ended up relinquishing that, going to overtime and losing by 3. Again, the men's hockey playoff game tomorrow night, 7:30 start with Adam McGuire at the Columbia Ice Fields against Brock, game one of their playoff series. I want to thank all our camera operators and producers this season, Mamiko Noguchi, Haytham Labrini, Derek Salazzi, James, Amanda, and Conrad Yu, who's been our camera operator and producer today. Their help is a huge component of how we bring these webcasts to you. Our football analyst was Ryan Wilkinson earlier this season, and football starts on Labor Day Monday under new head coach Joe Pow-Pow, and we'll bring you all that action live from Warrior Field on SSN Canada. The Associate Athletic Director of the University of Waterloo is Christine Stapleton, and the Athletic Director is Bob Copeland. And again, if you have any comments about our webcasts, good or bad, we'd love to hear them because we want to make these the best they possibly can be. Visit GoWarriorsGo.ca and find the email addresses for Dan Ackerman or Chris Gilbert, and they'll pass those messages along and figure out how we can improve on the webcast product that we provide you. 26.9 seconds to go. Harrison into Allen. Allen really coming into his own this past season for the Golden Hawks with 20 seconds to go, but a 3-second differential. Melbourne out to cause him some interference. Lots of bodies out in the back. They get Buckley by himself, and he's fouled by Angelini. For Zach, that will be his third foul, and will take Buckley to the line to shoot two. 7.8 seconds to go, however. And Pejicic will come in. He will replace Stigliano as they'll put some shooters on the floor. Wright, Melbourne, Pejicic, Bridge, Angelini. Buckley at the line to shoot two. We asked Coach Kieswetter about the decision not to foul. They had the lead in the waning seconds of regulation, and he said no way he would have done that. Said they just tried to defend the best they could and weren't able to stop it. That was against Western, as Buckley gets that first one to go, giving the Golden Hawks a lead. Juanis on the floor for the Golden Hawks. Buckley, Barry, Harrison, and Allen. And quickly into the game is Jamar Ford. Ford. Revelation as a rookie, they say. Wright looks up. He's got 5 seconds. Stops for three. Right wing. Hits it with 1.7 seconds to go. It's 96-91, and a timeout called by the Golden Hawks as Dale Harrison speaking to the official, trying to get some time added to the clock. Greg Figliano will re-enter the game in a moment. Huge play. Warriors were not going for overtime. They're going for the win. And Mike Wright cut in, took a step back with the defender right in his face, and nails the three from the right wing. So good off the dribble. And really beginning to perfect that shot. He will be something to see next season for these Warriors. Cam McIntyre on seniors night, his final game at home, still on the bench. Just outside of that huddle. Still grimacing in pain from what we can see. The officials still discussing the time, and it doesn't look like they're going to change it. So the Warriors just need to make sure there's no fouls. Contest the inbounds. ...1.7 seconds to go. Warriors break up the huddle now. Figliano replaced Pajic, who will sit right beside Coach Kieswetter. Warriors with Melbourne, Bridge, Angelini, Wright, Figliano. Allen inbound with Harrison, Enright, Buckley, and Coulthard. Enright with a shot. It's off, and the Warriors win their last home game. Kieswetter hugging Coach Dauber and tipping is a big hug to Cam McIntyre. Huge victory for the Warriors. You have to look back to that game at Laurier, a 110-60 loss by the Warriors. 50-point loss, and they come in and they play a team vying for an opportunity in the Wilson Cup. And a big hug from Bob Copeland for Coach Kieswetter. And a big crowd here at the Pack enjoy quite the ball game. Warriors winning 96-95 on senior night. The last home game for Cam McIntyre. And congratulations to the Warriors. A tough season for the Warriors. But they managed to improve their record. Playing a very good Wilfrid Laurier Golden Hawk team. Who dropped, the Laurier Golden Hawks dropped to a record of 16-5. They were sitting in second place behind Lakehead. McMaster had a record of 15-5 going to action tonight. Maybe in a tie now for second. Waterloo improves to 6-15. Their last game at Brock on Saturday night. Congratulations to Cam McIntyre. And thank you again to his dad, John McIntyre, for joining us in the third quarter. For our entire crew, I'm Sam Charles. Thanks for watching Men's Basketball on SSN. We'll see you next season. A reminder, Wilson Cup here on March 2nd and 3rd. Check out GoWarriorsGo.ca for tickets. Men's playoff hockey from the Columbia Ice Fields coming your way tomorrow night, 7:30 with Adam McGuire. Again, I'm Sam Charles. You're watching Warriors Men's Basketball on SSN.